Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th May, on the front page you have US curbs India to decide on Iran crude imports after poll. So this is regarding oil imports from Iran. So now it has been stated that India would decide on crude oil imports from Iran after the elections. So Iran has been one of India's top suppliers of crude oil in 2018-19. It also helped India meet its crude oil demand, 10% of its crude oil demand. And now we have to end crude oil import from Iran, which will be difficult for us. You can see the various countries from which we have been procuring oil. So Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Venezuela have all been shown here. So these are the top suppliers of crude oil from 2011 to 2019. Saudi Arabia, we have seen recently, has fallen, but this is overall for the past 9 years, 9 to 10 years. That is. Then this is Mamta's morphed photo. Supreme Court grants bail to BJP leader. So this is regarding Supreme Court. It has asked a BJP youth wing leader Priyanka Sharma to tender an apology for sharing a morphed photo of Mamata Banerjee on social media. Then below you have Sri Lanka blasts accused was on Indian radar. So the Sri Lankan blasts accused was wanted on Indian radar by NIA to National Investigation Agency because three Islamic State suspects were in touch with him and they have been charge-sheeted by NIA, National Investigation Agency of India. And this is regarding farmers facing water cannons as they march from Mohali to Chandigarh to condemn the policies of central and state governments. And this is at WTO, India moots unbiased assessment of trade policy. So this is further covered in detail inside pages also. So we'll see that. Then on page 3 you have project to use technology to study crop yield estimates. So this is a new project which has been initiated to study crop yield estimates. So this, once implemented, this will reduce delay in settling insurance claims by farmers and even increase accuracy. So these insurance claims are even made under the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. So crop yield information is essential for this scheme too. So there are these CC, crop cutting experiments, which are conducted. So the number of crop cutting experiments needed for accurate determination of yields have increased multifold. So Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana guidelines also call for 4 such CCs at Gram Panchayat level. So this new technology will actually do away with the requirement for CCs. So it will optimize CCs through technology. So this pilot project will be carried out in 11 states. So this is the detail regarding that. And this, you can see a new study to directly estimate yields without using CCs is also underway. So pilot project is underway for that too. Then on page 7 you have floods result of rampant construction. So this is a case before the Supreme Court on violation of CRZ, coastal regulation zone norms. So the court warns that such violations cannot be condoned and the floods which are happening are due to these rampant constructions. On the editorial page, the first editorial is missing demand. So this is regarding slowdown in the economy. Slowdown has widened across sectors. Demand is missing. And it says, the editorial says, the new government must hit the ground running. Means the new government will have a lot to do to ramp up the economy. And this is miles to go. So this is regarding South African politics. South Africa recently had its president stepping down and elections taking place, and Cyril Ramaphosa has won the elections. So it says the victor in South Africa's recent presidential election, Cyril Ramaphosa, should now take steps to reform the ANC, his political party too. Then the lead article is inching closer to the brink. So this is regarding US, how it is provoking Iran, and now it is on Europe to somehow stand by its end of the nuclear deal to ensure that Iran also adheres to it, which Iran actually threatened that it will also dilute the provisions for it. Then this is facing the climate emergency. So this is regarding climate change. So it says the politics of the climate crisis needs a radical transformation. people's movements are a spark of hope. So we have been seeing people's movements, even students, you know, movements taking place on climate change. So that is being spoken of too. Then the op-ed page has this article, Implementation Issues in 10% Reservation. So it talks of how a well-designed assessment mechanism is vital for the quota for economically weaker sections to work. So this has been announced by the present government, but to make it feasible and, you know, workable, there is an assignment mechanism which needs to be drawn out. Then on page 10, you have this news. Protesting Punjab farmers met with water cannons. So they were on their way to the Raj Bhavan and they had these fire cannons, water cannons fired at them. Then on international page you have US updates military plans against Iran. So US envisions sending 120,000 troops if Iran attacks American forces or starts work on nuclear weapons. So this is more confrontation in the Middle East in Iran, which is being seen now. And this is dozens arrested after anti-Muslim violence. So this is regarding the anti-Muslim violence in Sri Lanka. So the Sri Lankan PM also appealed for calm after a man was stabbed to death. A 45-year-old man who ran a timber store in Sri Lanka, he was stabbed to death. Below you have Israeli firm in WhatsApp, Floro. So this is regarding an Israeli firm which has been accused of supplying tools for spying on human rights activists and journalists. So this is now facing claims that its technology can use the messaging app WhatsApp, as such, which is used by around 1.5 billion people worldwide, to break into the digital communication of iPhone and Android phone users. On business page you have India fines OECD index for services trade faulty. So this is regarding OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, which comprises of the developed countries of the world. So it has launched this index, STR index as it is called. So this is services trade restrictiveness index. So this was launched in 2014, but then India says there are false flaws in this index. So it shows, this index shows Indian service sector is highly restrictive in areas such as FDI. So that is not acceptable to India. And this is regarding US retaliatory tariff. So the deadline has further been extended by India. So this is retaliatory tariff on 29 US products, which was proposed and has been extended multiple times. On page 14, you have Dr. Reddy's others deny fixing prices of generic drugs. So there are these generic drugs, and it is said many pharma firms are facing scrutiny under US antitrust laws for them fixing prices of these generic drugs. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. The PDF for daily current affairs is also uploaded there by the end of the day. So that is it. Thank you.